All right, we're coming back. And there's now face cams. Yay. Oh, yeah, I should unmute you guys. There we go.
Look, we're not going to re-woo for you, okay?
It's all good.
We wooed once.
Okay, so go ahead, Ronnie. Hit us with your best shot.
I kind of thought about introducing the special abilities under special circumstances.
Sure.
So I want to make a period of time.
Okay.
Or something where people discover other planets that have something that creates you having a special ability. Does that make sense?
Makes perfect sense. And I will even say it's related to the focus because it's using the space trains to travel.
Ooh.
Nice.
So yeah, you want to make a period? Sure, no problem.
Okay.
We're gonna make it here. Where do you want to make it, actually? Well, I guess it has to be after this.
Yeah, probably.
Oh. Uh-oh.
Just grab chunks of it.
Yeah, we're good.
There we go.
I spent a little bit of time reading about. Do you want it to be light or dark, Johnny? Before I forget.
Can I go half? I go gray. No, I mean.
This is the terrifying beige period.
The beige period.
I mean, it's kind of not only good abilities.
Okay.
Like, abilities that are good for people, but people will also get greedy, so I guess it can turn out dark.
Sure. Sounds good to me. So, that a thing here. People discover special abilities on other planets. Cool. All right. So there's your event.
Yay.
Yay. Yeah. So then we go around to the left. Sam?
Okay. So I want to create a period, and I want it to be a light period, and it's going to be right after the very first one, and I want it to be like an age of discovery. Because there's like coal power and all that stuff and steam engines, now people can get into the harder to reach places of this planet, the heart of darkness of their world, and they find the ruins of these ancient machines that were designed to go up and down the elevator, or the columns, that they don't know what they are yet. And these could form or serve as a kind of blueprint to the future development of space trains.
Cool. Sounds good.
I will do that now. Oops.
So yeah, I spent a little bit of time researching like ways to play this. Roll 20 is one of the more recommended ones. There's a few others. There's not really a great way to play this digitally yet. It was originally designed to be done with like cue cards in a real space.
Ah, right. Yeah, it makes sense.
Yeah. This works okay. It's a little bit slower than I'd like, but it's not ridiculous. But yeah, just random discussion. So yeah, I'm very much intrigued by the narrative aspects of this kind of game. For those viewers and people here that I've told, I got my Game Chef reviews back from the game I designed live on stream. And it was pretty positively received. Got a lot of work left to do on it, but yeah, some good feedback. Some good feedback. Yeah, I'm excited. Game design is hard. Difficult. Okay. So, Val, to you. Do you want to create a period, an event, or a scene?
To me, huh? I'd like to create an event.
Okay.
I guess during the worldwide energy crisis towards the end, because we haven't really figured that out.
Sure.
So I'd like an event where waterfalls are harnessed as a source of energy. Okay. I imagine that's the resolution of the worldwide energy crisis, right?
Probably.
Hey, there you go.
But, you know, history doesn't always work like that.
Fair. That's true.
So light or dark?
I think
you're going light. But,
yeah. Probably. I was trying to find a way to make it dark, but I'm probably going to.
If it's a solution, it's probably light.
Grim, dark, eco-friendly future.
There we go. Okay. People harness the power of the waterfall. All right, cool. So it goes back to me. And I'm going to create two nested things again. But I'm going to create a period and an event. If you could do these for me, Sam, that'd be awesome, because I need to think. I'm going to create a thing in between a period in between the first period and the Age of Exploration. And this is going to be a... what do we got? Okay. This is going to be a... As the people leave the cities, a new age of tourism starts. With the countryside trying to attract people out to, like, back out of the cities. And so they start a campaign. Go to my event. They start a campaign.
Sorry, light or dark?
Dark. They start a campaign of pseudo-archaeological digs in order to get people to see the wonders of the past out in the country.
Can you explain that in English to me?
Yes.
As a non-native English speaker.
Yeah, so the idea would be that with everyone moving from the country to the cities, the economy in the country is failing. So in an effort to generate more visitors to see the countryside, to make them money again, they have to come up with some sort of advertising campaign, some sort of way of getting people out there. So they, basically, they create this campaign of, like, archaeological digs.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A lot of them are fake, but they're there.
Okay.
So yeah, people are all interested in archaeology again. Hey, Yuveo, what's going on?
I saw him too.
So yeah, awesome. So that ends this round.
So I believe we have to select legacies?
Yes. Please explain what legacies are. This is actually the only part I really didn't understand.
I'm scrolling. So legacies are the common threads that may stretch through time and influence history. A legacy can take many forms, an object, a person, a place, a bloodline, an organization, or even a philosophical ideal.
Okay.
You make legacies to identify things you think are interesting and want to keep in the spotlight. Legacies are explored during a special phase, which is the phase we're in right now. So the player to the right of the lens looks back over what has happened during this phase or focus and picks something to be a legacy. It has to be something that appeared in play this round, either from the for the first time or reappearing from earlier in the game. And you can't make up something new. You have to single a particular thing out that we created, and that's going to essentially become a new palette element, kind of. But it's something that'll resonate through the rest of history.
Right. So the player to my right, which who have we decided is right or left? I think Drawny is left, and then Val is right, I think.
Weren't we just going in the order of names on the player order?
Right, so who's to my right?
Yeah, that was what I assumed.
Right, because... No, but it should be... Okay, yeah. So it should be Sam should be the player to my right, and Drawny will be the player to my left.
Because are you sure about that?
Yes, because we're gonna pass the lens left. And we're gonna pass it this way to from me to Drawny to Val to you.
That looks like the right to me.
Yes, but we've been playing it the opposite the entire time. So
yeah. The way we've got the play order right now, that's what it looks like.
So our play order goes what? We're saying right to left?
Yeah.
Okay. As long as I understand. So sorry, wait. Who creates the legacy? Me?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. Let's look at what we've done here.
Kind of hearing a sound that irritates me. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm hearing a buzz too.
Like a chittering.
Is that on my end?
Is anyone trying to like contact a space, an alien race here with some kind of Morse code?
I don't think it's me.
Is it me? Hold on, let's see.
I don't think it's me.
I don't think it's me either.
Who's that thing?
Actually, it could be me. I realized right this second that I'm not actually listening to the audio that you're listening to. Yeah, see there, it's definitely me. I'm sorry. I don't know if I can do anything about it.
What is that? It's just feedback or?
I'm using the webcam. I'm using a different webcam for you guys with a different mic so that it doesn't screw up my OBS.
Well, it's gone now, whatever you just did.
I moved them apart, so maybe that helped.
They were trying to talk to each other.
Yeah.
It's so silent.
Okay, so I want, so just to get back on topic here, I want this phase's legacy to be the first space train. I think that should go down in history as being a pretty darn important event.
Okay, so you have to create an event or dictated scene that relates to a legacy.
Oh, there it is again.
I will create an event that is... The next country over, Ostland, it starts their own space program, thus kicking off for real the space race.
Okay, sounds good. Okay, so just give everyone kind of a heads up. I think we'll do one more round and then we'll wrap it up. Because it took us like an hour and a half to do that one, so.
Whoops.
Well, we'll see how it goes. If we have time to do more, we'll do more. But I want everyone to get the same amount of turns rather than... and yeah, we'll talk a little bit about the game at the end, if we have time. You know, what we thought, what we think we'd do better, ideas we had about the storyline, stuff like that. If that's cool.
Works for me.
Yeah.
How long are you going to continue streaming?
Till 8, so another hour 15, give or take.
Okay.
That's the time I kind of told everyone, so... I know Derek's starting in 15 minutes, but that's fine. We'll overlap a little bit. It's all good.
Okay, so that's 2 a.m. for me?
Yeah.
Oh, gee.
It's okay. Johnny actually lives on Eastern Standard Time.
Oh, yeah,
I kind of do.
So then it works.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's move over there and everything's fine.
Here you go. Wouldn't even have any jet lag. Perfect.
Yes. Really wouldn't.
Yep. So yeah, Drani, you are the next lens. So you decide the focus.
Can someone just like simplify for me what this whole legacy thing was?
So basically the idea is that there's something that affects the entirety of the history.
Okay.
And it's not super apparent right now, but after we finish the next phase, someone needs to make another scene that explores a legacy. So they can explore either the one that we just created or the one that's created in the next round. So basically the idea is that these things that we've called legacies will continually be explored over the course of the game.
Mm-hmm.
So instead, like, you can't have the same focus twice, but because of legacies, you can keep adding to a certain idea. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Okay.
I kind of think so. I kind of want to think about what caused the whole worldwide energy crisis. Like,
okay.
If there was a certain event or something that happened that caused that, like not really just using some sort of vehicles or something. Or electricity, but something really bad happened.
Yep. Well, we'll explore that over the course of the round.
Okay.
So you're picking the worldwide energy crisis?
Yes.
Okay. No problem. Oh. There we go.
God, this noise is making me crazy. Now that I'm aware of it, it's just the worst.
The stream is purring. Don't worry about it. It's fine.
It means that it's pleased. It's pleased with us.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. It's because I'm using the shitty webcam mic on yours. On stream, you can't hear it because I'm using the actual mic.
Yeah, it's kind of weird because
Like
your webcam on stream actually looks better, and I wondered about that earlier.
It's because I'm using different webcams.
You crazy person.
It's the only way to do it, though, because OBS and Google Hangouts actually can't use the same hardware at the same time.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, so I literally can't do it any other way.
Hmm.
That's genius.
So obvious now.
So yeah, it is what it is.
Okay.
Okay, so Sam's gonna keep working on the legacy, I guess.
What? Well, I just topped it up. I mean, it's there.
Oh, is it?
I put the legacy on the left and the event in the sequence.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I can see it. It's great.
Excellent. Okay, so Drani, go ahead. You're the lens. You can make either one thing or two things, as long as they're nested.
In terms of that cause, that of the worldwide energy crisis?
It doesn't have to be the cause, but it does have to be related.
Okay. So, no nuclear stuff. what could possibly have happened?
No nuclear stuff wasn't actually selected, by the way. So that you don't have to worry about that.
I would kind of just like to ask this question and let you guys figure it out.
Sure. So make an event and a scene, and we'll explore the scene.
A scene?
Yeah.
Okay. So I guess there would be some kind of place that, or somehow a certain company or something that is responsible for all of the energy, and there's a headquarters, and people are starting to see that something is going wrong.
Okay.
Maybe.
So they're so what's the event you're creating? There's a the leading energy company whose name is what? It can be hokey, just name.
Spectrum.
Spectrum's good. Makes perfect sense.
It's just
No, like legit. It's perfect.
It's just the name that I see on the spray paint.
All good. Spectrum is perfect for energy. So Spectrum is collapsing. Spectrum is the first to notice what's going on. Like, how are they affected by, or how are they affecting the energy crisis?
Well, I think at that point they're just trying to figure out what is causing the energy what is the cause of the energy crisis that is about to happen in the future.
So we're going to say the event is light or dark?
Dark.
Okay.
Very, very, very dark.
Okay, so move this guy down. Put in this event. So, Spectrum investigates the cause of the energy crisis.
Yeah.
Okay.
But, I mean, obviously, they don't know there will be an energy crisis happening.
So the warning signs, then we'll say?
Yeah. Kind of.
Cool.
Don't you want that bottom one to be in a scene?
I thought we were going to make a scene out of this, but it could be...
Well, because you got two events there.
Right. But you can't just make a scene out of a period, right?
Right. But it should be a scene and an event.
Yeah. So I'm going to make it a scene now. Light or dark, Droney?
The scene?
Yeah.
Dark.
Dark. All right. Paste. Dark. So what happens in the scene? What's the question you want to ask?
Well, didn't you already ask the question? What are the effects of the energy crisis?
Was it the effects or cause?
Oh, okay. Well, fair.
What is the cause of the energy crisis?
Okay.
What could possibly have happened that this worldwide energy crisis is happening?
All right.
Yeah.
So what is the cause of the energy crisis? So I played it a little weird the first time when we were doing scenes. Are there any characters who have to be in this scene? You don't have to name, you may specify, I'm just asking in case you had someone in mind. If you don't, then we're gonna make up characters.
Probably maybe the... I'm missing the word. Like the boss of the headquarters, I guess, maybe.
The CEO? Sure. What's his name?
Mr. Spectre.
Sure. Sounds good.
Spectrum, it's Spectre. I don't know.
I'm in. Let's do it.
I love it. It sounds mysterious.
Mr. Spectre. Mr. Spectre.
It's like the perfect name for a shady CEO.
Okay. So who are you going to play, Sam?
I want to be the like alderman or mayor or something of the town downstream from the dam.
Okay. So what's your name and what town are you from?
I am from Evio, the town of Evio, because there may be someone in chat by that name. And I am Alderman White.
Okay. So Alderman White, mayor of Yveo. Also pronounced Yveo.
Yeah, Yveo.
How dare you question my pronunciation of my own hometown?
All right, Val, who are you going to play?
How about I am an independent investigator hired by the mayor to investigate this problem.
Okay.
Okay.
What's your name?
My name is Jerry.
I don't know why Jerry is so funny, but it is.
It's going to be Jerry Charles. I have two first names.
All right, done.
Wow, you must be important.
People get very confused. I get called Charles Jerry a lot. So, yeah. And you're correct. It is Jerry with a G, actually. Thank you for spelling it correctly.
Oh, wow.
That doesn't happen often.
I always spell Jerry with a G. Yeah, I actually do.
Nice.
I would have totally done a J. But...
I spell most J names with Gs.
What if it's short for Jerome, though?
Well, that's fair. You can spell Jerome with a G.
I guess you could. It's just not done much.
No.
Quick, let's all call Jerry Seinfeld and see what he thinks.
Hey, Jerry. Yeah.
Well, let me just open up my phone here.
Yeah.
So I am going to play. I'm going to play Autobahn.
I hate you.
So you're going to play the highway. All right.
Yes.
Love it.
He is a whistleblower within the organization.
Ooh.
Okay.
Could it be Otto Braun so that you have another color?
Why is it with the German today?
It just came to, it's the first thing that came to my head, and Sam always talks about Top Gear, so it's his fault.
Otto Braun.
The German show, what?
It's, you still talk about Top Gear?
Otto Braun.
Auto, there's many famous Autobahn racetracks, so I think that logic is sound.
Yeah. Yeah, all right. It's your birthday. We can let you get away with that.
Yeah, actually, your birthday is here in Germany.
Yeah.
Oh.
There we go.
It's true.
That's happy birthday from Germany.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Anyway.
Hey, don't sing that. We're going to get fined.
That's true.
Wait. Actually, I think it just was put in the public domain, wasn't it?
I think it's a legal gray area at the moment.
Hold on, I'm Googling this.
And that was in the States. Not all of us are in the States.
Oh, that's fair.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Just you, Val. You.
Just me.
Damn Yankees.
Well,
hey,
Val's actually
I'm
Canadian.
Not actually a Yankee. So I get the best of both worlds.
But she lives in New York.
Yeah, it's in the public domain since February 10th.
Oh, there you go.
Or they started kind of like processing it, so it's in the public domain. So,
weird.
Yeah.
Okay. So do you want to set the stage, Droney?
Sorry, I was just confused because Sam and not Q Sam,
there's too many Sams.
Sams just announced that Derek has started streaming.
Okay. Too many Sams.
All those other unimportant Sams.
Sure. Sure, buddy.
So,
sure. Like, that sounded reassuring.
So I have to, what? I have to start seeing or what?
Set the stage. What do we know? Where's the scene taking place? What's going on? Just give us any details. We don't need all of them. Just, you know, something to get us started.
I kind of just imagine this like a movie scene. Like, just
sure.
People, like a lot of people with a lot of screens and people are kind of panicking and running around.
All right. Sounds good. Sounds good. So where are you? Are you in your office?
Yeah, before the scene starts, and then
okay.
Maybe someone is coming in and
okay.
Kind of says that that something weird is happening, and I'm going to this headquarters screen room.
Okay, like the stock exchange? Is that what you're going for?
Oh, I think we just got raided and then Nightbot completely owned it.
Oh, yeah? What? Stevie Ray Vaughan tried to raid. I appreciate that, Stevie.
Oh, no!
Sorry, Stevie.
Oh, God.
I tried to fix that. I actually made it higher than it was last time. My bad.
Wait, what did I say? Small raid.
Yeah. Things are happening. Things are happening. My bad.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. My settings must be really, really hardcore, apparently. So So you, what's happening in the scene, Ronnie? Tell me.
I guess that the start of the scene will be that people are noticing on the screens first that that there are a lot of warnings that there's something not right, like just like lights beeping, and I don't know. Since I'm Mr. Specter, what the hell is the whistleblower supposed to do?
So basically, in this context, I told the CEO, but he didn't listen. So I'm now going to start spreading information to the outside world.
Wow. Okay. So, I think I'm gonna call Mr. White.
Okay.
And, yeah.
Okay, so my phone rings and I pick it up. Hello, Mayor or Alderman White?
G'day, it's Mr. Specter. I think we have a problem, and it seems to be spreading around Ivea.
What is the problem?
I think that our systems tell us that that some systems are failing and energy is running low.
Wait, so you're telling me the town isn't going to have enough power to operate?
I think that's exactly what I'm telling you.
How can that be? You've already choked the river off almost completely. There's barely any water even running through, and you can't generate enough power?
I don't know what's happening. I think I will call you back. I have to hire an investigator to see what's happening.
Sure, it's probably going to be some guy called Jerry.
I will call you back.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. So next I'm going to call Jerry Charles.
So my phone rings. I pick up, hello, this is Jerry Charles of Charles Investigations. How can I help you today?
G'day, my name is Mr. Specter. I'm the CEO of Spectrum. And
holy moly, you're the CEO of Spectrum calling me? Wow. All right. How you doing?
Yeah, my cousin told me about you.
Oh, your cousin, that's great. I love it. So what can I do for you, sir?
I think we might have a problem, and it's supposed to be, like, you can't tell anyone about it. It's a secret.
Jerry Charles is known for his secrecy. I promise you, this stays between us.
Okay.
You have the Jerry Charles guarantee on that.
I want you to investigate on something. We discovered that in Ivea there are some energy problems, and we don't know what is causing it, but some systems seem to be failing, and I'm quite worried about that.
Okay, wow, that's quite a big thing that you're asking there, but I can get my team on it. But I'm sure you want this to be on the hush hush down low, right?
Yes.
Like, okay. So we're gonna try to keep this very quiet. I'm going to need access to your staff and to your computer systems. But I can come into your office this afternoon and we can get started on this.
Okay, I think that sounds good.
All right, awesome. We'll discuss a rate too when I come in.
Yes.
Okay, I like money. See you then. All right, thanks. Charles out.
Charles out. Nice.
He doesn't say, Jerry Charles does not say goodbye.
All right. So, what happens next, Ronnie?
Yeah. I think we skip forward to the afternoon and, or even further, maybe. I sent Mr. Jerry to investigate the problem.
All right.
But on the way, Otto Brunn kind of seems to be sniffing something.
Sure.
So it's kind of a scene between Jerry and Otto.
All right. I'm in.
All right. Sweet. So, sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, okay. So I'm like leafing through my file folders, like looking for stuff when you walk in.
Okay. Oh, hi. What you up to there? I was Mr. Spectre gave me access to those files for my my investigation. Jerry Charles. Hello.
What? Who? What?
The boss of your company?
I'm not doing anything. No. What?
It looks like you were doing something.
No, I wasn't doing anything. Shuts the
I come and sit down next to you and put a hand on your shoulder to stop you from going anywhere. And I'm like, "No. You can tell me. I'm an investigator and I'm trying to figure out what's going on here and no one will give me anything. No one's telling me anything. And you know, I'm just trying to do this for the good of the people."
Who did you say hired you again?
The people hired me.
I am
the people's investigator. Listen, okay. Let me tell you something. Mr. Spectre hired me, but I think there's something shady going on in this organization. And if you think there's something shady going on here, I want to know about it.
Well, there's definitely something going on. I mean, those new testing facilities they installed in the valley last week, there's been some strange readings. I mean, I brought them to Mr. Spectre earlier on, but he, he kicked me out.
Did he? Well, that's interesting.
Yeah, I don't know.
Huh.
I mean, there wasn't anything like super weird, I guess, but it was strange. Like,
what was strange about the readings?
Well, so our company generally monitors tectonic movements in order to better predict weather patterns and things that might, you know, affect our bottom, like affect our service. And I've been noticing with these new installations that there's a lot of strange things going on. Strange things. Just really? Weird readings. I'm not quite sure why yet.
Would you be willing to share the results of those readings with me? I promise you your name will have no bearing on this at all. We'll appear nowhere.
Sure, no problem.
I always keep my sources anonymous. That's the Jerry Charles promise.
So, here's the readings.
Okay. Whoa!
So, you'll see here that this is actually taking place over the course of about an hour.
Holy moly.
Yeah, I mean, that's looking like earthquake level, but it's not an actual earthquake. So, I don't know. I'm just a lab tech, you know, like I just look at the data. I don't look at other things.
Right. Well, let me take this into consideration and bring this to my sources. And then
all right.
We might have to, I mean, if Mr. Spectre isn't willing to do anything about this. Anyways, I'll take this into consideration.
Okay. Sounds good. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Brown.
Thanks for listening, I think.
You're welcome. Charles out. I walk out.
Okay.
All right, there we go.
So we haven't answered the question yet.
Oh, shit. Excuse me, I don't know if I'm allowed to swear on this.
It's okay. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Family-friendly stream. Oh, shite.
No! I'm sorry, all the children that are listening.
Okay. I'm actually going to use a mechanic called push here. And it's going to be really funny because I'm going to push what I said.
Okay.
And I'm going to push that... Autobron knows exactly why the tectonic plates are shifting. It has to do with the blasting, and what they're doing is they're actually disrupting coal and water lines. So there's a lot of water being flowed, being drawn back underground, filling cavities.
Thanks, Mr. Spectre.
Thanks, Mr. Spectre. That's my proposal. Any additional proposals? You can now suggest your own ending.
I think that sounds great to me.
Okay. So vote, all four?
So hold on. How does the shifting tectonic plates cause there to be an energy crisis?
Because it's rapidly destroying all the natural deposits of other sources of energy. Oil pump lines are getting crushed and destroyed. Mines are being wrecked.
It's creating like a fuel shortage.
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yes, it is.
Okay. All right.
Put that in there.
Yeah. Okay. So we all vote. Yay.
Yay.
Yay!
Okay.
Five fingers for that. I think that's how you're supposed to vote.
Yes. So cool. We answered the question. So next. So you did two there, Johnny. So next is Sam's turn.
Yes, I'm finished.
I'm frantically trying to make that into a text box and it's not working. Hold on a second. Okay, so what's our focus is still the energy crisis.
Yep. Keeping in mind, you do not have to put that in the period of energy crisis. You can put it wherever you want as long as it's related.
Yeah. Well, I think I should create an event, another energy crisis event.
Okay.
Or no, you know what? How about I make a scene under the people harness the power of waterfalls.
Okay.
And it can be a scene where it's a scene at the completion of a huge dam, like a Hoover Dam equivalent.
Okay.
And so it'll be a light tone scene because it's this thing's finally been completed and they're about to switch it on and it's going to power, the entire Eastern Seaboard or whatever in this world, okay. In this country. So I guess my question is for the scene is what problems does this renewal of power resolve? Like, how does this make things better?
Okay. All right. So, do you have any characters that must appear in the scene?
I think Mr. Spectre should definitely be there.
Okay.
No way this dude does not have some sort of interest in this.
Fair enough. For the record, Drani, you do not have to play Mr. Spectre this time if you don't want to.
Okay.
He's now a global character. Like, he's part of the timeline. Anyone can play him at any time. And use him as they will.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's it. That's the only person who definitely has to be there.
Okay. So, who are you going to play, Sam? Are you going to play Spectre, or are you going to play someone else?
I will play the engineer in charge of the dam, like the chief engineer. Engineer O'Brien.
All right. Dr. O'Brien it is.
It's an entirely original name. Created by me.
Okay. Who are you playing, Val?
I guess I can be Mr. Spectre.
Okay, cool.
Sounds unless someone else was really tied to being Mr. Spectre. Suddenly he's a...
He didn't go to school for 8 years to be called Mr. Spectre.
There we go. Between the time of, you know, the breakdown and the resolution, he got this doctorate.
It's a PhD in power management?
Yes. There we go.
Okay.
It's an energy crisis is the best time to do that, right?
Sounds good. I am going to play the son of Alderman White, whose name is Jerry White after his cousin.
Aw, Jerry.
Who is a reporter. Who do you want to play, Johnny? Or do you want to just play, like, all the random villagers, people? But you play whatever you want.
That's kind of what I've been thinking about, actually. Well, what the hell are you doing?
Sorry, I was closing my door. Don't mind me. I just realized I left it open. Carry on.
I kind of want to be a bunch of people who are totally against this because there might be people who want to create more waterfalls and villages are gonna get blown away and people have to move and stuff.
Okay. So
you're all the villagers from the catch basin.
And the angry villagers.
Torches and yelling, it's gonna be great. Pitchforks.
All right.
The anti-dams, I love it.
This is my fork.
All right, so go ahead, Sam. Set the stage.
So all of the important people from nearby, political and economic and all that, are gathered on the top of the dam. The most important people are at a big ribbon that goes around one of the turbine towers that's like just beside the dam, and they're about to, you know, break a bottle of champagne over it to initiate, to whatever, to, you know,
yeah,
make it official.
Okay, sounds good. So
I think O'Brien says, well, I'm glad everyone has joined us here today for this momentous occasion. We'll finally be able to provide power for our people, to improve our quality of life, to alleviate our reliance on coal, and, you know, just generally make the life of our people better. And he swings the bottle of champagne at the thing.
Mr. O'Brien. Can you comment?
Sorry.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
Can you comment on the all of the people of Yaveo who were died in the energy crisis because we didn't have this dam?
O'Brien completely misses the turbine with the bottle and spins all the way around, narrowly missing your face with the bottle, and just barely gets himself into control and says, well, I know there's been a lot of crisis or of austerity measures that we've had to put in place because of the crisis, but this dam is a direct response to that. We are trying to solve that problem.
Can you confirm or deny whether or not Spectrum had Alderman White assassinated?
Look, Spectrum is a major funding source for this project, and I can't possibly confirm or deny any rumors, political or otherwise. I mean, we're here to celebrate. Why are you trying to bring us down?
I just want to find out the truth.
The truth is this. This dam is great.
You're denying the assassinations of political figures in order to push this dam through.
I maintain turbines. I don't know why you're asking me about a political assassination.
Well, you're the chief engineer, aren't you? Or are you not the chief engineer? Did you assassinate the chief engineer?
I did, as is our tradition, that you keep what you kill. I did assassinate the previous engineer. So I'm not really sure why you're even asking me this. The previous engineer, Riddick, had got to go.
Engineer Riddick was well loved by the people.
I feel like these questions should be directed towards the mayor, or you know, someone in political power. I'm a servant of the people.
Well, you know that the mayor is just a puppet for Spectre now, right?
I'm not sure that that's true. I know that they provide a lot of campaign funding, as they do to our organization, the EVO Power Ordinance, but you know, I can't confirm or deny any of your accusations.
Where is Spectre? Shouldn't he be here for the opening of the dam?
He is here. He's just over there.
Hello. Yeah, I'm there. I'm waving to some like folks in the crowd. You know, I'm doing my whole CEO look at me kind of thing. I've got the giant scissors to cut the ribbon.
I run up and like throw a punch. You killed my father!
Oh, what are you doing? Guards, get him!
I trip and fall over the over the edge of the dam, plummeting to my death.
Well, this did not go as expected.
This was supposed to be a light scene.
It's not done yet.
Okay, all right. 3 days later, he comes out of the river and he's fine.
There you go. No, I turn to the crowd and I make a speech. I'm like, ladies and gentlemen, this is what disagreeing and, you know, anger will get us. We will fall down the dam of our own anger if we keep going this way. Now, this dam here is here to solve all our problems, and yes, sacrifices had to be made, and yes, we lost things during this great energy crisis, but this is a step forward. We now have found a renewable resource that we will be able to use to make our future better, so let us not fall down the dam of our own destruction. Let us move forward and climb out of the river.
Nonsense!
And most importantly, remember that this new dam will be able to power numerous mills, so we'll be able to create more flour and make more bread and feed our people properly, so we can avoid the privations of our recent past.
Hear, hear.
That was a pretty good speech.
Thank you.
So yeah, I think that answers the questions.
Yeah, and a reporter incidentally died and no one seemed to care.
Well, you know.
Wait, what was his name? Riddick or something?
No, that should not be canon.
Too late. Way too late for that.
Oh, goddamn it. What have I done?
Man, poor Jerry.
Yeah, Jerry, I mean, really, a victim of his own success.
Really? A victim of his own clumsiness, I would say.
All right. So it's your turn, Val.
Oh, lordy. Okay. So, our focus is the worldwide energy crisis. So So we figured out the beginning of the crisis and the end of the crisis.
Yep. And like I reminded Sam, you don't actually have to add something to this specific period. You can add it wherever you want on the timeline, as long as it relates back to the energy crisis.
Got it.
Hold on, I'll be right back.
All right. See, I'm intrigued by Ostland creating their own space program.
Right.
Is not Germany the name of the country that we're primarily in right now?
Yeah, not Germany.
Un-Germany?
Not
Germany. Okay, not Germany.
Not Germany.
Got it.
It's canon. It's in the scene. It's in the event. It's written in the event. It's not Germany.
So I don't know if this would relate to the energy crisis, but I would like to know how Ostland is creating their own space program.
Okay.
Like, I don't know if they have access to the space trains.
Okay.
Or if they're on the same space train trail, or if they're vehicles.
Okay. So how does that relate to the energy crisis?
Good Lord, I don't know. This is very energy focused, which is not my strong suit. I'm not very scientific.
but think about it, the example that they give in the book is that they talk about things like archaeologists many years in the future finding things relating to an event, or in the past maybe there's something that started somewhere in one of the other ages that started our push towards an energy crisis, or...
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
This is work. This is real work.
Man. Okay, so... We also got the start of our timeline that we haven't really played around with much.
Yep.
Dude, I'm like drawing a blank here.
You could pretty much play this forever.
Yeah, you can, which is why we're gonna have a hard limit.
Yeah.
They talk a lot about it in the book about multiple play sessions and certain things, and it gets kind of crazy. But yeah, it's certainly an interesting exploration. Do you want to pass then, Val? And I'll put something in and then you can come back.
I would love to pass.
Okay.
That'd be great.
So I'm totally going to steal your thunder.
Go for it.
Because I have...
It's your birthday. You can steal all the thunder you want.
Because I have an idea. So I'm going to make a scene, and I'm going to try and make it as quick a scene as possible, because we only have 25 minutes left. But I'm going to make a scene under Ostland Creates Their Own Space Program. And I'm going to say how did Ostland... how do you spell Ostland?
O-S-T.
Yeah, I got it. How did Ostland steal everyone's energy during the energy crisis in order to start their program?
Oh, that's easy. Time of use rates. That's theft right there.
I think that was a joke. I didn't get it.
Nobody else here knows Ontario power politics, apparently.
Yep.
That would be a no.
I'm the only other person who lives in Ontario, bro.
I'm not even from Ontario.
Yeah.
I really wouldn't care.
Neither do people care.
Yeah, we're the wrong audience for this. For Ontario power jokes.
Okay. We have 25 minutes left, so we're gonna try and keep this as short as possible. But feel free to explore. Feel free to explore. But I think people that need to be in this scene are Major General von Metternich. Needs to be in this scene. And I think there's going to be a competing general named Steve.
That sounds so important.
General Steve.
Yeah.
Oh, good old General Steve.
Yeah, so another
two first name person. Was this like Frank Steve?
Maybe. This is Roger Steve.
God, that's worse.
Oh, Roger Steve. All right.
Better. Bam.
When this guy's on the radio, it must just be so confusing.
Maybe.
Roger Steve.
Well, you know, that's why he's a general. They promoted him up so they didn't have to listen to it.
He's as bad as Major.
Stevie says Roger Stevie. So done.
Roger Stevie.
Perfect.
Now, are we all acknowledging what you just said, or are we saying the name?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe a little bit of both.
Okay, so Roger Stevie is a Auslan general. And Major General von Metternich's there. And so I'm going to play Major General von Metternich. Who do you want to play about, Johnny?
Decorative llama. not German.
senior.
Yeah, he's the father of Senior Junior.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, he's a villain from Kim Possible.
Oh,
it's the worst.
Yeah. So, who do you want to play, Johnny?
I think I'm the very nervous intern.
Okay.
Mr. Metternich's. I guess, or assistant intern, something.
Okay, sounds good.
It's my first day.
What's your name?
Lieutenant Einward. Totally not your name backwards.
I'm just Andy. I don't know.
Andy? Done. Andy the intern.
Okay. Andy the intern. I love it.
Excellent
name. Who are you going to play, Sam?
I am the assistant to Roger. What was his rank? Roger Steve?
He's a general.
Okay, I am the aide-de-camp to Major General Steve, or Stevie. I am Major Tom.
Major Tom.
Okay.
And I guess that would leave me as Major Stevie?
Yes, you are Major Stevie.
Major Stevie.
Major General Stevie, sorry.
There we go. Oh, yes. Get my title right, Major General Stevie.
Okay. Okay, so we are in Major General Stevie's office on the Auckland DARPA base.
Oh my God.
Auckland DARPA base. And I walk in the door. Thanks for meeting me, Major General Stevie. It's good to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you, General von Metternich. I shake his hand. Please, have a seat.
I came here today to discuss with you a business proposition. You see, there's this guy named Zeitgeist, and he's kind of a loon. So I was wondering if you could kind of stop him.
And how would you want me to do that?
Well, you see that he's kind of developing this space program, and I couldn't sneak the blueprints out, but I was really hoping that your side would have a lead on it that maybe I could help with, as it were.
Well, let me call in Major Tom here. I believe that he's been dealing with this case.
Okay.
Sir, yes? Sorry, what are you talking about? I was taking notes.
Oh, excellent. Good, you're here.
I think ground control was calling you.
Ground control to Major Tom?
Yes, exactly, yeah. Major Tom. Ground control being me.
Coming loud and clear.
Hey, excellent. Wow, I'm sorry, guys. I'm like losing track here. What's going on?
It's okay.
Yeah, sorry, we were talking about the energy crisis, I think?
Yes, I'm sorry, I didn't have breakfast this morning. I'm a little spacey. My apologies.
Fair enough.
Yes, we were talking about the... I don't know if we were talking about the... Yes, the energy crisis. Zeitgeist.
Zeitgeist, yes.
Yes, Zeitgeist.
My nemesis, Zeitgeist.
Zeitgeist right. has been conducting... all sorts of strange research, sir. He is looking into a number of different ancient artifacts, which he proposes were constructed by ancient aliens.
Ancient aliens. Psh.
Yeah, the guy's a loon. Aliens don't exist.
All right. And what do you want me to do about this?
So let's just say that Zeitgeist, you know, We're just discussing possibilities here, but Zeitgeist may be using a newly discovered energy source in order to develop magic.
Point of order: there's no such thing as magic.
Well, you know, magnets, right?
It's true.
Oh, magnets does sound a lot like magic. You know, sometimes the two can be confused.
Our people have long thought magnets were magical.
Exactly.
Indeed.
We live in an age of enlightenment now.
Yeah. We do indeed. Thank you, Major Tom.
So, so what we're going for is I don't have access to that energy source, but I may have access to a stockpile that we made about 40 years ago, if you remember what was going on back then.
Yes, indeed.
That no one really knows about. So I could help possibly, you know, just speaking figuratively here, I could help with a new source of energy for you to get your program off the ground.
All right, I would greatly appreciate your help, but I assume that this help won't come without a price. I assume you're looking for something in return.
Yeah, so A, I want you to deal with Zeitgeist. B, I need you to keep my name off the books and out of this, because we are not discussing treason here. And C, I need a vacation getaway home in the mountains.
Ah, yes, in Ostland's famous mountains.
Right, those ones.
Sorry?
Those ones, yes.
Yes, those ones. Yes.
Definitely not Alps.
No, not the Malps. The Malps are very beautiful at all times of the year.
Yes. My health is failing a little, and I need some some fresh air, as it were. Also, that zeitgeist is driving my stress levels mad.
I can imagine that. Mad scientists tend to do that.
Right. So I'm going to call in my intern, and he's gonna bring in a sample for you.
Excellent.
So, Andy, get in here.
Yes, what is it? What is it?
Do you got the sample?
I think I forgot it. Wait, let me go back.
Wait, you forgot the sample?
I'm sorry, it's just my first day. Please don't fire me.
Oh, I won't fire you. Go get the sample.
Okay.
I'm going to shoot him later.
Yes. Yeah. That's probably a good plan. He seems a little twitchy.
Yeah, a little odd. We have a deal.
I would like to see the sample first, but tentatively, we have a deal. I can make this zeitgeist disappear. We can easily get you a cabin in the Malps. And I will, of course, keep your name off the books. That is very easy to do.
Excellent.
I keep my sources secret, sir.
Excellent.
I'm back. Here's the sample.
Ah, yes.
Pull out my pistol. Shoot, Andy.
I recoil and dive behind a table.
Why is that guy so twitchy?
I've got my sidearm up and I'm just like, just my eyes over the edge of the table.
It's okay, Major Tom. Major Tom's had some previous trauma.
Fair enough.
It's a little jumpy, but can you please put that pistol away in my office?
Yeah, you got it.
I don't appreciate the use of firearms within my office space. You know, it ruins the zen.
Sir, of course, sir.
Gotcha. Fair enough. Had to be done. All right.
Yes. Major Tom, can you please get the janitorial to come clean up this intern situation, please?
I rush over to the wall in intercom panel and just call for a red cleanup. Is there a code for this?
Nice.
Of course there is.
Okay, so we answered the question.
Yes. Yes, we did.
There's a sheet ghost on stream. Getting real spooky in here.
Spooky!
Whoa.
Metternich sold them to the Osterlandians.
Oh, snap.
Yes, and they're Osterlandians, not Osterlanders.
Got it.
Osterlandians,
yes.
So Metternich's a traitor, is what you're saying. He sold off the reserves for his own personal benefit.
Yes.
Oh, man.
Oh, because he hated Zeitgeist so much.
Poor guy.
He totally wanted to see the Malps.
He just wanted to go on a Malpine vacation.
Those Malps. Okay, so Val, you can take your turn.
Switzerland.
Indeed.
We got 10 minutes.
Wow. Okay. So we're still in the energy crisis, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Energy crisis. This is my trick. I'm just going to sing a song long enough about the energy crisis, and then time's going to run out for my turn.
Yay.
Energy crisis. I really don't know, guys.
Okay. Do you have anything you want to do before we end, Ronnie? You still have your last lens turn.
I'm kind of still intrigued by the people discover special abilities on other planets.
Right.
Thing.
How does that relate to the energy crisis? I'm not saying it doesn't. I'm just saying, how does it?
Uh, kind of wondering what the abilities could be and how they would be useful for this crisis. So,
okay.
So maybe some ability could be that people just get super intelligent, or can run super fast, or
okay.
I don't know.
Just bolt like... a flash to a treadmill.
They did that in The Dark Knight Returns.
Well, that jerk was asking for it.
Yeah.
Moving faster than light. What did he expect? Laws of physics aren't just suggestions, man.
They are laws for a reason.
Yeah. Can I make a suggestion? Is that cool? I know we're
sure.
not supposed
I mean,
to,
we can...
but... We're not supposed to, but I just, in the effort of moving this along a little bit.
Well, since this is the last one, we could just work this out as whole thing, since we're all just, like, getting a bit confused and stuck in this whole energy thing. Or, I don't know.
Well, I was just going to say that the special powers allows... for new developments in energy manipulation, thereby solving any past or future energy crisis. Maybe. I don't know. I was just thinking out loud. No? Yes? Maybe? Just floating around here.
I mean, it makes sense to me. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe. Yes, maybe so.
I like it. I mean, it's fine. How? What are you... okay, I see what you're writing there.
Yeah.
Solving it.
And future crisis.
I fixed it. Is that cool? Sound good?
That's like everything we're moving around the energy crisis stuff.
Well, that's how it's supposed to work, right? Like, you're supposed to be able to talk about it in terms of the grand scheme, not necessarily just in a specific period or anything like that. They don't want to limit you in that way.
Yeah, it's kind of like there's recurring problems through history, cycling through like more than one power crisis.
Yeah.
I mean, like, kind of like real life. I mean, why did England started burning coal? Because they chopped down all the damn trees.
Yeah, things happen. So, I get to set a legacy, but I think we're going to skip that for now because we got 5 minutes.
That's
so,
my favorite part.
Yeah. So yeah, start closing out a little bit here. So we just played Microscope, give it a test. I was really into this game because I love the idea of narrative history and constructing narratives. I mean, that's what we do on this writing show. And yeah, fun party time because it's my birthday. Did everyone enjoy it?
I liked it. Yeah. I liked it more than I thought I would.
Yeah, it's a little weird to get used to. I think if we were all a little bit more experienced, it would go faster and we'd get into it more. Mm-hmm. I also think we picked hard things. Things like energy and all that get really difficult.
Well, you know what I think the biggest problem was here? We went too small. This is too short a time.
I actually agree with you. I feel it felt a lot more confined than it needed to.
But I guess that's part of it, right? It just sometimes you get a small story, sometimes you get like a millennia long epic.
Oh yeah, totally. Go ahead, Val.
I mean, when you
I guess
when
the you... oh sorry.
I started making scenes and stuff, it gets very specific.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, that's part of the point.
I think kind of like the mental block that I had with it, because it was fun and it was interesting, but every time I've role played and done stuff, even with storytelling games, I've had some sort of parameter. Whereas this had, yeah, some kind of guidelines, but it felt like it was very freeform. So in a way, it was even more difficult to come up with stuff for me because, you know, I don't know if that makes any sense, but
it does.
Used to
kind of
having at least some boundaries to play around in.
Because from what I saw anyway, you were kind of struggling in like the in the creation stage, but once we put you in a scene, like you're gung ho, and kind of just went for it.
Yeah. Characters are what I do. It is.
Yeah. That was so weird.
Yeah, and see, I'm a premise guy, so like I see the big picture, and characters are not nearly as important to me. Totally. So yeah, any last thoughts?
Yes, Charles out.
Charles out. All right, stay on the line. I will talk to you guys during the outro in a second, but I'm gonna mute you for now. Yeah, so last, just for the stream, guys, big thank you to my friends for coming and chilling, playing games with me. That's Drawny, MC Pack of Profits, and my good friend Val. So yeah, I'm gonna throw it over to John Derek Murphy's birthday stream. I moved things around so that we could both do the same thing because this was the only day we could both kind of do it. So yeah, he's a good friend of mine. Come hang out. I'm gonna be hanging out there after. Other than that, I hope y'all enjoyed it. Check out Microscope. It's really cool. I'm going to potentially, I'm going to discuss with the guys and gals after, but I'm going to save this and maybe use this for a future writing project on Accidental Origin. Other than that, peace, take care, Charles out. I'll see you all later. Bye.